Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Welcome to another edition of Scientifix, our weekly curation of globally important science stories.
NASA has unveiled a legal framework that lays a set of principles that countries and companies in space and on the moon should follow. The document, Artemis Accords, includes the creation of safety zones around sites where mining and exploration would take place on the lunar surface. As the U.S. Space Agency aims to send astronauts back on the moon by 2024, the new legal framework reiterates the country's long-held stand that companies should be allowed to extract and use resources on the moon. NASA is likely to make it compulsory to sign these accords as a requirement for allied countries to participate in its lunar exploration program. The proposed framework is in line with the 1967 Outer Space Treaty, which prohibits nations from laying claim to the moon and other celestial bodies. A part of the Chinese rocket launched into space on May 5 crashed into the Atlantic Ocean, narrowly missing New York City. The Long March 5B rocket was launched from the Wenchang Space Launch Center in South China. The spacecraft has been in development for 10 years with the intention to carry large payloads into low Earth orbit. The latest prototype was over 50 meters long and weighed 849 tons when it took off. The rocket reportedly had difficulty breaking out of the Earth's atmosphere. Experts suggest that this may have been the most massive object to make an uncontrolled re-entry since 1991. Meanwhile, scientists have discovered hundreds of fossilized human footprints made between 5,760 and 19,100 years ago in Africa. The findings represent the largest collection of fossilized footprints found in Africa to date and may shed light on what life was like in ancient communities. The study described 408 footprints, which form 17 different tracks. Researchers believe that the footprints belong to 14 adult females, 2 adult males, and 1 juvenile male. About 56 human footprints had become visible at the site in 2009 due to natural erosion. Excavations between 2009 and 2012 uncovered the rest. The 17 tracks were all made moving at the same walking speed in the southwesterly direction. The footprints are a snapshot offering windows into anatomy, locomotion, and group behavior. Skeletal fossil data is also rare in this area, which makes the footprints even more intriguing, according to the researchers. Researchers in Australia have created heat-resistant corals that could make reefs more resilient to the devastating effects of bleaching. Increasing ocean temperatures compel corals to expel tiny algae which live inside them, effectively starving the corals. Researchers from University of Melbourne in Australia created a strain of microalgae which is more tolerant to heat. These microalgae are injected back into the coral. The findings may help in efforts to restore coral reefs. Australia's iconic Great Barrier Reef underwent back-to-back bleaching events in 2016 and 2017. This year, the corals experienced the third bleaching event in 5 years. The next step is to further test the algal strains across a range of coral species.
This is Mohana Basu for The Print. Do subscribe to our YouTube channel for the latest updates.